Hello guys, welcome back to another video. Okay, sorry guys. Hello, welcome back to another video, and the reason why I'm whispering is because it's late at night, I'll show you. And I got my SpongeBob, fairy lights, and my piggy bank. And the chocolate apple will have to fit in my bin. I'm still, because I was painting my walls, these walls the other day. And stuff I don't want to even show you. I was a mess right now with my penguin. Let's go get my penguin to get cozy. Okay, anyways. So today I'm going to be reading some rainbow magic books. These are not all my rainbow magic books, these are actually just some of them. The rest of them are downstairs and in my loft, so I'll have to get them soon. It's Christmas time, 21st of Christmas, 21st of December, and I want some more room for my Christmas print, so let's space some room. So today we're going to be reading, where is it? My finger's just on it, okay. Saffron, the Yellow Fairy. So this is Saffron, the Yellow Fairy. So put it down here for better background. So she's got some yellow shoes, a crop, yellow crop top with a pink butterfly, blonde hair and stuff, and a lovely wand if you can't see that, and some sparkles. Rainbow magic, and this is a Daisy Meadow one. Okay, and it's Saffron the Yellow Fairy. So I'm gonna read this to you. So much pages. If you've never heard of these, they're really good books. It's good for getting yourself to sleep. So let's go, my bed. It's a school night, it's Friday, it's Thursday, tomorrow is Friday, and it's my last day of school, so we're not doing any work, thank the Lord. So I'm quite excited to go to school tomorrow. Not really always excited, but yeah. So my camera cannot balance right now. So Saffron, Yellow Fairy. So these are all the books you can get. So these are all her sisters. So far, they've been captured by Jack Frost and they've been flying places. So I've read Ruby the Red Fairy, it's a really good book. And Amber the Orange Fairy, and I'm on Saffron the Fairy. Okay, Saffron the Yellow Fairy by Disney. I don't know what kind of fairy it is, I think it's okay. So these are, they'll tell you like, where all the places are and what they look like in the story. So yeah. So contents. Give you time to read that. That should be enough. Okay. A fierce bee. If you don't know who Kirsty and Rachel are, they're who will catch the fairies to help them. So to explain, over here Kirsty called Rachel Walker. Kirsty ran down the emerald green fields covered as part of Rainspell Island. Buttercups and daisies dotted the grass. Don't go too far, Kirsty's mom called. She and Kirsty's dad were climbing over a oh god, I can't see. I'm looking at the camera, that's why. I can't pronounce that, sorry. I'm just so tired. I'm like, I need my glasses for this, but. Okay. So, Kirsty caught up with her friends. What have you found, Rachel? Is it another rainbow fairy? She asked, hopefully. I don't know. Rachel was standing. Okay, actually, I'm going to give you a time to read that, because I can't I can't hold this camera inside the book. So if my camera's bad, just on the bank of playing streaming right here, guys. I thought I heard something. Kirsty's face lit up. Maybe there's a fairy in the stream. Rachel nodded. She knelt down on the soft grass and put her ear close to the water. Kirsty crouched down too and listened really hard. The sun glittered on the water as it splashed over Beck. Shiny pebbles, tiny rainbow flashed and sparkled red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, and violet. I think that's Kirsty. That's Rachel. I'm not sure if I forgot. And then they heard a tiny bubbling voice. Follow me, it gurgled. Follow me. Oh, Rachel gasped. Did you hear that? Yes, Kirsty. Her eyes wide, as it must be a magic stream. Rachel felt her heart beat fast. Maybe the stream will lead us to the yellow fairy, she said. It's hard for me to read with gold glasses. I got them at school, so it's going to be hard. So I'll give you some time to read this page again. I'll show you pictures after you read. That should be enough time. Here's a picture. Rachel and Kirsty smell like each other.